No one could translate competitive advantage into bullet points the way he could, and his relevance and importance persists today. Of all his works, the competitive forces model is his most important legacy. The essence of it is that firms should seek out industries that offer high profitability due to weak competition. Once found, they should take action to keep competitive forces down or find calm corners where market forces are the weakest, otherwise their profitability will directly suffer. Tees, Pisano and Schuon, 1997. It's a simple principle. If the number of competitors goes up, profits go down. The slices of the pie get thinner. To make the approach more practicable, Porter, in 1979, 1980 and 1985, broke down the competitive forces to five pillars that have an impact on profitability levels. The bargaining power of customers, the bargaining power of suppliers, the threat of substitute products and services, the threat of new entrants, and rivalry in the industry. Porter, 1979. Retail banking has always been an attractive industry, according to this model, but as we've seen, industry structures can change through innovation, whereby new technology unfreezes, changes, and refreezes them again. This is exactly what the blockchain will do, and here's how. The first force is the bargaining power of buyers. What currently weakens buyers' power in retail banking is that they're too dispersed. They have no joint lobby. There are no individual customers that drive proportionally high chunks of the revenue as better-off individuals turn to private bankers. Though financial switching costs are low and the customer has the power to unilaterally change the supplier, it hardly ever happens.